Hey, have you ever wondered when you are like just dragging around your thing and then you wanna this? I cannot move my mouse because there's an image, and yeah, that's kind of strange, right? So I go to this image and I cannot do anything about this. So question is, how do I get this image to be clickable on the background? So to do this, we are going to remove this image. We're going to create a container, put it in here, like this. We're gonna edit styles, change background image, take my watermark or whatever you wanna call it, and just, well, set some opacity or whatever, and just say on this container, because a container is the only element that can do this. Transparent parts clickable is just unselected like this. And now, when I preview this, I can just go around and just click here as well. So this is really nice. And this has got me thinking, hey, wait a minute, if I can do this, then I can also do this. Create a huge watermark over my virtual tour for maybe clients that, you know, haven't paid yet or something. I don't know. You know, you could basically create a watermark like this. So this is like one thing. But then I was thinking a bit more than that. So I thought, what if I add like a background, like an overlay color? So what I did is basically created something like this. 20% black. Hey. 70% black. Woo. 90% black. And that got me thinking, 0%. And that got me thinking, okay, so that means that I can start a virtual tour with 90% black, and then man, I should have done white text. And then, you know, as you go through the tour, you can see more and more and more of the virtual tour. You know, that's like a use case. Maybe e-learning, maybe just because you like it yourself. So, well, you can do black, you can do blue, for example. The way I created the black background is basically a container. I put it in there, make it very big, and I say edit styles. And I remove these colors because these colors are not going to make you allow the clickable thing. So removing these background colors and just set background image. And basically in just Photoshop, I just created something called black. It's 9020 by 1080 pixels. And this I'm just going to put in here. The opacity I do not set in Photoshop, like that's just like here, just 100%. But within 3D Vista, I can set the opacity. So I can say 90%. And then you can animate these containers as well. So what I did in here is I basically have a show components and a height components. Just to show you from the start, show height components. And then I can basically check this black box and say on click show. This thing with a delay maybe of 1 second and return after another second. So it just flashes up, something like that. And I've been playing more and more with this. And well, I had some creative idea for this. So as you maybe already noticed, do not click the TV. You know, don't do it. Well, if you say don't do it, people are usually wanting to do it. So, you know, let's click it. I told you so. Oh no! What do I do? Relax, man. Take a rest on the couch. Okay. So, you know, these are like some creative ideas that you can do with this overlay thing in mind, with the containers and transparent background images. And then one last thing that popped up in my mind was to have something such as one last thing that I had in mind was to create just another one. And one last thing I had in mind was this thing. So just going to create it from scratch like this. Hoppa. And then we go to add styles. Right click to remove them. Change background image. And have a texture and say done. And now I can say, you know what, let's do a very subtle texture, something like this, and put it on there. And then you have like this, well, maybe this is not the right texture, but you can imagine you just Google for some other texture images that you just put as a background there, which is just this little extra touch of a design thing that's like, yeah, you know, and so this opens up a whole new world in like designing a virtual tour, and it gives you a lot of creativity to fine tune it and make it even cooler than it already is. So I would say good luck on this, and see you in the next video.